show.
Hello, people. Welcome to the show. My name is Mariah Folabi Brown. Thank God I have my lovely co-host here. Hello, ladies.
Hi, Mariah.
That was a bit abrupt. I didn't know we were on already. How are you doing, Ima?
Looking very colorful. Well.
I will like say, the yellow combination today.
Thank you to my sister for the beautiful dress.
Oh, yeah.
And this weekend for me was very inspiring with the T.Y. Bello's Jumoke discovery story.
What happened?
I just want to pray for T.Y. that, you know, that the God that gave her the heart to see good in that girl will continue to bless her. Then the girl herself, you know, there's something we call about first impressions. There was this bread seller who walked into a photo shoot T.Y. was doing. I think Mariah is looking like me.
I have no clue what you're talking about.
She doesn't know the story. Okay. T.Y. was doing photo shoot for Tiny Temper, and a girl, a bread seller, hugged her bread and walked into the photo shoot. Into the shot. And, you know, T.Y. took a shot of her and later put a search on social media for her. And someone said to her that they're looking for you. They found her. And now she was on the cover of This Day over the weekend.
Aww.
You know, beautiful girl.
Beautiful.
Very inspiring story.
Beautiful girl.
I'm telling you, very inspiring. And, you know, her life is just a 360 degree
right now.
So T.Y. is like pushing her forward, talking to Kulia Folayo, that Jumoke, T.Y. Bello. She's talking to Kulia Folayo that Jumoke wants to act, she wants to be a model, so she's already signed to a, an agency, and that if you want to use her for anything, just please contact the agency.
You know,
such a beautiful story. Within a week,
the girl her life was is changed. A mother of two.
Yeah.
You know, she has so much to do that, you know, she has to get by selling the bread.
Oh,
and good for her, she was well dressed.
That's
most
why
of the
T.Y.
time when you see them
for...
the picture wasn't upsetting to T.Y. That's why she looked for her. Most of them when they dress is always, you know, tight.
Fantastic.
And tough.
Well, all right, anyway, how was your weekend, Takwe? Powering all the way.
There was party, but then I don't have power and I'm not sleeping well. I run the gen and it's been 3 weeks of bad sleep. It's really, really bad. And I went to NEPA office. It's really power old. And I think
what power is it? The disco?
The disco, and you would think that because it's a privately run business now, they will be more organized. There is a marketing manager called Mr. Malamo who has given us a bill. We are ready to pay the bill over a week now. It should come to the house to ascertain what is going on. You will just go there. They say the person is not around. His phone is switched off. His appointment is not. It doesn't come to the office. And I said I'm going to mention his name. His name is Mr. Malomo, and he's in this Magodo office. Why would you keep people 3 weeks? It's so bad. And this is our fourth week, and he's not doing anything. There should be processes that people should be in the office. When you get there, you meet them. His phone is switched off. You tell you I'm coming. You ask questions, nobody answers you. As in, they don't answer you, they just ignore you. Literally, like you don't have a job to do. Just be resuming.
I think from the papers we're going to talk about a lot of the power later.
Yeah.
There's supposed to be a resolution committee or something to help you resolve this kind of issues.
When
so hopefully.
On a flip side, your hair looks really nice.
Really nice.
Smile small.
I like the curly thing.
Yeah,
nice.
It didn't work out as I wanted it to.
But it's fine.
Hi, Joe. Hey, how was your weekend?
I'm a Nigerian, not a criminal.
It's in the papers anyway, so you get into it. I was partying all weekend. I went to your party for 10 minutes. I wish your aunt saw me, but unfortunately she didn't see me. My one of the relatives got married on Saturday. Sunday I went for a baby dedication. In fact, it was party all the way. Well, I had a great time this weekend, actually.
I'm happy you did.
All right, let's take a quick break. When we come back, we'll go through the front pages of the newspaper. Stay with us. We'll be right back. Welcome back. All right, let's start with the punch. Budget padding. National Assembly demands probe of minister and top officials. Picture here. Residents fleeing Mairi village in Kunduga local government, Borno State. Oh. Oni is first among Yoruba monarchs, says Alake.
It's often wrong.
Fayose withdraws workers' salaries after payment.
Mm-hmm.
12 million Nigerian motorists carry fake insurance papers. Yeah, we knew that. Ekiti poll scandal. DSS quizzes ex-PDP secretary Aluko. Arm scam. Bade faces EFCC interrogators today. State's external debt rose by 270 billion naira in 5 years, says DMO. And 30 die as trailer crashes on Lagos-Ibadan Expressway. lots of stories. We want to do the only story, the Fayose story, or the 12 millionaire.
Governor Fayose is in the news again.
What happened to him?
Civil servants in Ekiti State received alerts on their phone for their November-December 2015 salaries.
Mm-hmm.
On getting to the ATM for some of them to withdraw, they met nothing there. The government had, you know, ordered the banks to return the monies. Mm. And you know, everybody was just disappointed.
Start from the beginning. They were going to protest. Mm-hmm. And the governor said to them, don't worry, we will pay your salary so mm-hmm. you don't protest. And then they got alerts, only to get to the bank and hear that, there's no money in your account.
And I question that because we know banking-wise, policy-wise, nobody has a right to take back money from my account. Once it gets to my account, I have the right to say, go transfer back. So there's something fishy about that is going on.
That's what the informational Commissioner for Information in Ekiti was saying, that you know it is an error on the service provider mm-hmm. side. Not you know, I don't know which not service provider, government. Whether the banks or the network or the telecoms. But he's saying
so
that
should we give them the benefit of the doubt?
But he also said that some of the workers who were fast enough to get their monies withdrawn, they were going to look into it again. In the same report on the punch.
So it is really fishy there. Because if it is an error, the ones who have withdrawn their money, you should let them go.
Yes,
and this is November, December salary. Can you imagine? In February.
All right, are we picking another story in Borough?
So you wanted to take the Oni story. Did you see ex-president Obasanjo prostrating to the Oni?
That's
over
a true Yoruba man.
That's him. In fact, now I respect him.
A lot.
Me too.
He has collapsed because he respects him.
No, but that's true.
You must respect the
ex-president, whether or not you've been a two-time, three-time president. It doesn't matter when it comes to traditional ruler and, you know, our traditions, we know what applies. And he just showed people the right example.
Yes.
That no matter who you are, this is the Oni, and that is, you know, my tradition. A true Yoruba man.
Yes.
All right, whatever.
So the Oni is the premier Yoruba Oba.
As said
no
by the Alake of
Egbaland. No dispute.
Of Bagbadebo has acknowledged. So the other brother was saying that, Aromularon.
But I was educated that the Aromularon's throne is very well linked to that of the Oni, being that, you know, they were also, both of them originated from Odua directly. Aromularon was the last child, direct descendant of the Odua, and, you know,
that
fetch.
How do you guys know all these things?
Let's move on to Vanguard. 2015, PDP goofed picking Jonathan. Says who? Guess. Fayose.
He's always in the news.
That's your governor. He's always in the news. Your governor now.
He's your governor. Check with.
He's your own governor.
He's my husband's governor, not my governor. 17 days in Lagos Super Road accident. I'm not denying you, Governor Fayose. I'm not denying you. Yes, I'm my governor by marriage. Oni remains highest ranking Oba in Yoruba land, says Alake. How will spend 500 billion naira social welfare program fund corruption? Amechi then Bruce clash. I know you're ready for that one.
We are ready. How should we go?
Talk about the 500 million.
Which one do you want to talk about? Because
Let me tell you about the 500 million. So the federal government is saying that once the budget is approved by the Senate, they're going to start to disburse 5,000 naira to 1 million poor Nigerians. That this is a five-phase poverty alleviation system. They're also going to be giving students a meal a day in schools. They're also going to be employing unemployed graduates, about 500,000 of them. They're just telling us how this social welfare of 500 billion is going to be spent. Okay. Moving quickly to Amechi and Ben Bruce. Or do you want to take another?
Go ahead, please.
So over the weekend, I'm a Nigerian, not a criminal hashtag
was trending.
It was created by Ben Bruce because our president was talking to a gathering of foreigners and was explaining that Nigerians have no one else to blame but themselves because there are a lot of Nigerians in foreign prisons, you know, for drug trafficking and things like that. And Ben Bruce came on Twitter and said he was upset that I'm a Nigerian, not a criminal. Because there are some criminals out there does not mean that all of us are criminals.
There was a guy, Omojua, initially sent a text.
Yes.
Saying, I can't remember what he said.
Saying Ben Bruce was the person who was quiet during Jonathan's administration and, you know, he would rather not be a Ben Bruce and, you know, making a lot of noise now.
Then
and
Ben Bruce then also
replied.
While he was in his tweets, another one, he now said that while the president is calling us criminals, his minister spent 80 million.
Allegedly.
His tweet was that your minister spent 80 million on one dinner in one day, and you are calling Nigerians criminals. Now, Amechi now tweeted and said that Bembus is a coward for not mentioning the minister that mentioned the name. Bembus now replied and said, when you have been wicked,
you become
wicked.
Hey, oh, that's what they call rhyme.
Robin, seen Twitter fight between celebrities and all that. Now, we're seeing Twitter fight
interesting.
Between politicians. You know,
Amechi doesn't do Twitter well. Yeah, that's the area of specialty. Of
Bembus.
That's where he
Bembus now said, we are still brothers, though. But, you know, we are still your beloved brother. Anyway, moving on very quickly to Daily Sun. Crackdown on Boko Haram. Army moves 1,000 soldiers from Lagos. Picture here of the Lagos Ibadan Expressway. You can actually see some bodies there. I think the trailer that fell over. Opera over hidden bank charges. Federal government goes after $750 million, 7 million pounds. Abacha Ibori loots. All set for Zekome's book launch tomorrow. 39 Lagos Ibadan Expressway. This was Zekome's book launch. Everybody's talking about it. I wonder. I mean, these 20 governors are planning to attend. I'm wondering. Okay, it's been in paper since last week.
He's doing a very good PR job.
Yeah, fantastic PR.
His PR person should be paid extra. But the story that
the 30 people that died.
Yes, and I feel so sad about this. We've been seeing this happening over and over again, where trailers come with mostly northern trailers, trailers carrying human beings in addition to the animals and okadas, people relocating in mass southwest. This is the case. You
coming
have
from
rams
Castina State.
From Castina State coming with rams and human beings, and they were all loaded inside the trailer. Now the trailer had collision with another bus, tipped over, people fell down, and we lost 30 lives. Mm. And it's according to the Sun. What it means is that we've seen this. The FRCN has seen this. The police has seen this many times. Nothing was done. Now we lose 30 lives, and probably they will start making some moves. We should ensure there's a policy on ground to prevent.
They are actually very, very.
I read that story in the Punch.
People should not travel through this. This is not a means of transportation
for
human beings.
You can't avoid it. They paid 1,000 naira from Katrina. Any other means of transportation, they would have been spending between 7,000 and 10,000 naira 5,000. To travel to Lagos. Mm. Lots of these people are poor. I've had megads. A lot of people who are traveling to Lagos, they will take 7 days on the road traveling with animals just because of poverty. Mm. So we need to address poverty first before you start telling FRC to stop.
But then emergency response
like
is very important too.
They
because the witnesses around in the story, when I read it in the Punch, were saying that response was very slow. And you know, people lost their loved ones. According to the report in the Punch, a man stood between two dead bodies that he covered their faces and was crying, chanting the name of Allah, saying that, you know, he lost his loved ones. Response should be swift on the roads. We should have express. Like we have in Lagos, we have emergency posts. There's one at Antony, like that, like ambulance post on the expressway. We should have them along the expressway all the way out of Lagos.
Well,
it is well. May their souls rest in perfect peace.
And we need to call our minister. Please hurry up with these roads.
I agree. Yes, Minister Fashola.
Mr. Fashola, you know, we'll start calling your name very soon.
Yes, sir.
After we're giving you some time. After that, we'll start calling your name. All right, this day, our last paper this morning. Senator Garbai, Boko Haram still occupies half of Borno. Wike Amechi spent $150 million to fund APC's campaign. Dangote to construct new cement plant in Ituri, Okpela. Audit report reveals how lawmakers diverted 100 billion naira constituency funds. And labor protests, federal government moves to secure electricity installations nationwide. All right.
All this media crisis. If you have proof to say that Amechi spent that much money, then take it to.
Well, you know, he's now governor, so he's still power is back in his hands. But you know, am I in or am I out? Now he knows he's in. He's going head down looking for Amechi, saying that you get $150 million.
I wanted
spend
to take the Garbai story.
Sorry?
Boko Haram. Boko Haram still has control over Borno State. You know, that story has been disputed. Garbai is one of the senators for Borno Central. And while he was visiting Dalori and some other communities recently attacked by Boko Haram, he was, you know, lamenting seriously that the people were not, that Dalori, for instance, was a safe city, and that Boko Haram had given them notice of an attack. They had reported to the officials, but nobody did anything, and all that, you know, disputing what the president said. But the Senator Ndume, the majority leader, has come out, he's also from Borno, to say that, no, that's not the story, that things are really improving in Borno State. So,
all right, that's all we can take on Front Page Review. When we come back, the new electricity tariff in Nigeria. Stay with us, we'll be right back. Welcome back. Now, we know that the National Electricity Regulation Commission, NERC, has unveiled a new increment of an average of 9 naira 60 kobo and 14 naira 80 kobo electricity tariff for all classes of consumers of the product, which will become effective from the next billing period, just as it also announced the abolition of the contentious fixed charges for all electricity consumers. However, the Nigeria Labour Congress, trade union and civil society allies set protest against the new tariff. We have with us here the Vice Chairman Campaign for Democratic Workers, Mr. Dagatola. Welcome to the show, sir.
Good morning, Nigerians.
Yes, yeah. Good to have you on the show.
Thank you very much.
Now, we have all been talking about this electricity tariff since last week. We've had complaints, oh, I don't have meters, I'm doing, they're giving me the automated billing, they call it
estimated billing.
Bwaike has several times complained about the fact that she has to pay these kind of the additional bills. Now, your group, that's the Labour, now said last week that they're going to start protest from Monday today.
Yeah, this morning.
Exactly why?
Well, the issues are extremely very clear. Nigerians are extremely suffering under extreme excruciating conditions, and having to read through this process is not something Nigerians, you know, want to accept. So the major slogan for this campaign is that we are not going to pay, we won't pay, we can't pay. Interestingly, if you had to examine the electricity sector of the Nigerian economy, you know, we've had it so worse. Since the privatization in 2013, you'll be amazed how much of our resources has been plunged into electricity.
That's true.
Don't forget again, the past 16 years, over $20 billion has been expended, in spite of the fact that we have been told that this outfit has been privatized. Then, this is a new regime, quotation open and close. The first question Nigerians are asking is that we expect the Buhari regime to return back to examine the electricity sector. The series of resources that has been plunged into the electricity sector. Because if this regime is fighting corruption, Nigerians should not be made to suffer for the corruption in the electricity sector.
True, sir.
That is one clear point. We must also bear in mind that there have been series of increase before now. And at no point has there been improvement in electricity supply. So the Minister of Power should not use an increase as a reason for improved supply. Because Nigerians should not be deceived. The total megawatt for Nigeria has not gone beyond 4,000 as we speak.
But I thought, see,
and the private sectors who have taken over have not added one single extra megawatt.
We all go through power issues. Everybody here has one story or the other. But in our being patriotic, understanding we have a new government, they have a new blueprint. Fashola came two weeks ago, explained to us that, listen, no matter how much you increase or decrease, you're still going to have to pay for extra services, whether we like it or not.
I'm really happy you have reintroduced the question of patriotism. Must patriotism be only on the part of ordinary Nigerians?
But can we trust the government?
Shouldn't the billionaires also be willing to be patriotic?
Are they not also being paid for it right now? We have them in because we are arresting them. We are taking our money back from them already. So shouldn't we? I'm just trying to understand why there's, as much as we understand the point of the Labour, there are Nigerian citizens also who believe that maybe we should even let this government fix this problem.
Exhausted all dialogue forms with which we can resolve this issue?
Now, let me inform us that content of court charges will have to be filed against NEC, as well as possibly against the minister. Because as we speak, there is a court pronouncement that there should be no increase in tariff. Lawyer Toluwani, you know, has a suit against NEC and the DISCOs, and there is a subsisting injunction that has stated that no increase should be carried out. So it's going to, it will even offer a litmus test, you know, for this, because it's a democracy. Judiciary should not be toyed with.
Mr. Daga, there's this thing out there that the DISCOs are not doing enough to, you know, to capture what they are giving out. They give more power, but they can only capture a few areas. Do you agree that some Nigerians are using power without
now paying? Let's not mix up issues. And I just give one concrete example. The Ikeja Disco last year announced to all of us what they have made, comparing, you know, their profit margin. And you'll be amazed how much resources have trickled into their pocket. Using Yosho the area, according to them, you know, and the percentage average of over 2,500 percentage profit margin compared to a 2-year period. So the truth is that they are making more money into their pockets. But and I think, like I heard somebody said here, services are extremely poor.
Casualization. I'm not complaining that all the money that they're making, they're still paying back. Remember that they're having issues paying back.
I am actually on the side of Labour.
Me too.
For
me
this.
Too.
And I agree with the protest.
They've been bailed out so many times. I've not seen.
They've given them. I think that as much as we're fighting corruption in other sections of the society, we need to fight the corruption that has to do with PHCN and the sales. And also, the bailout fund they've gotten over and over again should be audited.
Yes.
How was the bailout fund spent?
Exactly.
And why should they now ask the increase?
I have a question for you, sir. So, this protest, because the Minister of Power has asked for a meeting today, saying he doesn't want any protest, let's dialogue, let's negotiate. What is it that Labour wants exactly now?
The point of dialogue is to revert to the existing former prices.
Mm-hmm. And then moving forward, what do you expect the government to do?
What we'll expect the government to do is what has been pronounced here. One of the first things we'll expect government to do, like we have all pointed out, is to even offer Nigerians a Monarotian period.
Okay.
Don't forget that we have paid so much. And what these discos have given to us is darkness.
We
should be Nigerians in a period of patriotism, in a period of relief. Yeah. Nigerians should be given a 6-month billing free payment period.
Really?
It's a business.
I agree.
On that, I am a little.
Don't forget.
Do you people want this country to go forward at all?
Nigerians have paid. I think we should even come back to what the minimum wage is in this country.
18,000
naira.
Yes.
And you are asking families to pay 7, 8, 10, 12,000 naira for electricity.
My father pays for no power.
One of my demands from this that I want, and because you're representing
us.
All of us labor workers, is that the law, the statement on ground by NEC, which is that only as people with prepaid meters should receive this new billing system, should be insisted upon in such a way that somebody that is not, you don't know how much what I'm consuming, I shouldn't be forced to pay whatever bill you send to me at any point in time.
They've done that, yes.
I read the article yesterday.
They are discussing it.
Saying that those with the, what's the ultimate?
Estimated billing.
Those ones, for now, they will not bill, they will not collect them, they will not be required to pay what is owed. Only the last one that is verifiable.
Can they have access to verify that?
How do they verify?
The way this thing works in reality is that in the communities, you know, take Agor, for example, where we led a massive protest mid last year, you know, and prepaid meters were installed in the whole of Agor, Kota area. Yeah. You know, there have been a slight difference because with prepaid meters, you are only paying what
you consume.
You consumed.
Yes.
But the state of anarchy that existed in most communities in the country is a situation where estimated bills, you know, are offered. And the discos enjoy this era of estimated bills.
True.
Because it does 2-3 things for
but
them.
But the highest culprit for me is Ikeja Disco, because First Tag Disco has, you know, made sure that a lot of people get that. As long as you apply, you get your prepaid meter. But in Ikeja Disco, they will tell you some areas that they are doing it in batches and I'm focusing on the major areas,
Mabodo, and I agree Ikeja, with them. Central. I am also under Ikeja Disco, and I'm able to say that they've done well in my own
in your area.
Yes.
Ikeja Disco covers all the way to Alimosho, Igondo, Obadore area, stops at the Obadore, and people have been applying for these prepaid meters, and you're saying that they are not entitled to it.
I think that there won't be power for 3 days. We're doing... Do you understand? All right.
So maybe well, they've been overwhelmed. We need to take a quick break now, because we actually tried bringing somebody in from either Ikeja Disco or NERC, but because we're having a very crucial meeting this morning with the minister, we couldn't get somebody, but we were able to get somebody else from the public opinion analysis convener of the Power Up Nigeria, I believe, the Power Consumer Advocacy based in Lagos. So hopefully they can hopefully help us shed more light on exactly what NERC is trying to do. Stay with us, we'll be right back.
Okay.
Welcome back. We have the convener of Power Up Nigeria, a power consumer advocacy group, Lagos chapter, Adegbemle. Is that right?
Yes, Adegbemle, yes.
To enlighten us more on this tariff issue. Now, to give us a call, you can call us on 0708-066-8014. You can tweet to us at TVC Connect, and please hashtag your view TVC. Now, you heard what the Labour gentleman said. As I said, we wanted to bring someone from NERC because they are very involved in this. But unfortunately, they have a meeting with the minister right now, so we couldn't get them. But you are part of an advocacy group for Power Up Nigeria.
Yeah.
What is your understanding on the reasons for this tariff in comparison to the fact that Labour is planning to protest against it today?
Mm. Well, the question I asked when I first heard about the Labour protests was, okay, where have they been the last 2 years?
Mm.
What have they been doing?
Good question.
For me, this is an opportunist move. Government settles them. I shared the same opinion on the radio station just this morning. This is an opportunity for them to, hey, we are still here. Are we going to get our own parts and that kind of move? So I'm not particularly taken by the move of Labour today. Mm. This issue of power didn't start yesterday, it didn't start last month, it didn't start even while Buhari was, you know, May 29th last year. It started way back. Now, there has been a lot of development along the line, which culminated eventually to the privatization of some segments, the distribution aspect and the generation, right? And from day one, part of the demand that Power was asking for, or has been asking for from the one, has been one, remove the fixed charge element of the billing system, which they have done now. But I will tell you, it is a matter of giving me one shoe and giving two shoes and taking one leg.
Mm-hmm.
Two, get everybody metered.
Mm.
Very important.
If you get people metered, lots of the issues that we're having today will not even arise at all.
True.
And automatically, it knocks out our toll demand. No more estimated billing. What's estimated billing? Okay. How do you estimate it?
Question, sir.
Please go ahead.
Now, as much as we question the motive of Labour, and they know that we don't trust them so much.
Please don't let us make Labour issue
but
here.
Some of the things that they are demanding makes total sense to the Nigerian consumer. Do you agree?
Since you want us to go that route, I'll go back to that same statement. It's not a one-off thing. And before you start demanding for something, you need to understand the system.
Okay.
It's a whole big ecosystem.
Mm.
We're talking about Ikeja Disco metering people and stuff the other time. You have to also realize that these meters are not cheap.
Mm-hmm.
People are willing to pay.
If you look at the figure, the question is this.
I paid over 50,000 to get prepaid meter in my house. I'm not supposed to pay, but I paid.
Wait. Meters are not cheap.
Mm.
You're ready to pay, right?
It's not
but the regulation behind it, it's not making it easy for you to get the meters.
What's the regulation, sir?
Well, right now, it's only the discos that can give you meters. But what if the discos don't have the money to stock up the meters?
But they've been bailed out how many
several
times? President
the Labour man that just left here now just talked about several about bailouts that they had.
See, we even on this show, we've seen them being bailed out.
Wait. First of all, you have to agree to the fact that why am I speaking for the discourse? I'm not defending them. But you see, what I'm trying to establish here...
You're being realistic and objective.
No, what I'm trying to establish here is, first, you have to understand what is happening.
Okay.
Right. If you understand what is happening, then we can sit down and say, okay, fine. At what point do we come in? Yeah. When we're talking off here, I said, this issue of tariff increase is a question of chicken and egg. Which one comes first?
True.
You understand? The minister and everybody that are for increase of tariff keep saying that we must increase tariff so that we can get services.
Yes.
But don't also forget that in the last 2 years, we have four tariff increases. Well, reviews. Don't let me use the word increase, but reviews.
Mm-hmm.
Right? Has that led to
more power?
Have you been receiving more power in your house?
No.
So the real issue is distributing the meters, not so much of the tariffs.
Even if you have the meters, right, you won't have problem with the tariff.
Yes.
Then again, let me give you this angle. They said they removed the fixed charge.
Yes.
And they increased the tariff. Mm-hmm. It's not maintenance, fixed charge. They got the fixed charge. They removed the fixed charge.
And then increased the tariff
from, let me use Kejari Square as an example, from 13.1 naira to 21, that's 8 naira increase.
Yes.
What you have just done is to do a peg on you.
Spread the fixed charge.
Good. By the time you use more than 70 units or 75 units in a month,
you have paid the fixed charge already.
The fixed charge. So if you use more, you're actually paying more.
True, sir.
So for me, I think we are fighting for the wrong thing. I think Labour is going to the mark to the world now to go and fight for the wrong thing.
What should they be fighting for?
One, metering.
Very important.
That should be the focus. I'll say this. Will you use service network without your phone?
No.
If you buy 100 units and you call 2 minutes and it goes off, won't you call the customer support and say, hey, what's happening?
Yes.
You understand?
Because you can measure what you're consuming.
Exactly.
Yeah. All right, let me take this call. Good morning, Idris, I believe. From Sokoto.
Idris. Yes.
Good morning, go ahead, please.
Go ahead, though. I want to contribute on your topic.
Yes, go ahead.
This is Idris. Yes, sir. Yes, hello. Can you hear me?
Yes.
I want to. I'm a first caller.
It's actually delayed.
Mara, for me, I blame the NERC, that's the Regulation Commission, a lot. I remember last year, 2014 in fact, the boss of the NERC came out to say that they were going to regulate and compel discos to give out meters. We were all looking forward to it. But how far did they take that? They didn't implement it. Now, discos go on and on, making it difficult for people to get prepaid meters. And when you don't get it in some areas, they charge those areas. There are some, that is one. Another thing the discos don't do, there are areas that have not been captured where, you know, they don't have these areas under their records, but their staff know these areas. They go there and get paid. Now, you go to a shop. That shop does not have prepaid meter. You say, okay, don't worry, I'll give you power. That's the staff of PHC.
Pay 3,000 naira
and then pay 10,000 naira a month to that person. That is one money they've not captured. So even when they are using so much to generate power, they cannot capture a lot of what they're doing because they have not even seen to the corruption within their system. Now, innocent Nigerians who are willing to pay should not be made to suffer. If I approach any discourse that I want prepaid meter and I'm even willing to pay for it, I should get it firsthand. I shouldn't be delayed.
They don't have the funds for these. No. But you see, part of the recommendations we made, according to that, on the metering, is this. This is not like it's peculiar to Nigeria. These are issues that happens all over the world.
Yeah.
In South Africa, for instance, you have metering service providers. What these guys do is, oh, you are a Kejari disco. I am a meter service provider. This is standard of meters that we want. I'll go, source for them, bring it to you. We calibrate them. Then if you need meter, you don't go to them. You come to me.
Okay.
You open up the ecosystem.
Yes. Let me take this call from Enugu State. Okay, calling from Enugu. Okay.
Hello.
Good morning. Okay, go ahead, please.
Yeah, good morning.
Good morning.
Good morning. Yeah. I want to appreciate you for your program.
Thank you, sir.
It's quite educating.
Thank you.
Yeah. Actually, the tariff increment is not a bad step anyway, but it's quite wrong in the timing. The timing is very, very, very wrong. So what I want to suggest that let the government, the federal and the NDC government, try to give us a better increased supply in life. Let's have a better life. Let's have about 18 to 20, 22 hours life supply. Then we'll be able to pay any tariff. Mm. Even if we have to pay 20 more increments, you know, we're doing, we wouldn't mind. You know, so let us, 20% increment, we wouldn't mind. There are the increments first thing first. Once that is established, then we'll be able to, you know, go ahead. Let's have increments in light supply first. That should be the first thing. Once it's established, then we can now make an increment.
All right, thank you so much.
I agree with him.
Let me take some tweets when you're done.
When, like she said, when you change the name, they've changed to Power Holding, they've changed to Discos now and handled by different people. Mm. But the same people that were there under NEPA are still there right now.
They complained when they wanted to sack them.
They have new bosses who probably have better mindset of how to run the organization, but they have not done a culture change for those in charge. So now you have internal crisis and ineffectiveness within your place. I am willing to pay for service. I go to NEPA. I don't see the bosses in charge of the small area, Magodo area. I ask them, I want to pay them. Nobody answers me because I'm not going to offer anybody bribe in any way.
Yes.
And so that cuts me off from quality service.
Bad customer service.
I think that apart from these people, the people at the helm of affairs might have good intentions for what they want to do, but those that are making that 3,000, 5,000 naira from lack of metering will continue to let lack of metering be
let's take
the
some
situation
tweets.
On ground.
Let's see some tweets, please. Samuel Stevens says, in my area, the PHCN staff that I know had no car, but before we offered prepaid meters, you used to poor people to make money and buy themselves cars. Obina said, EEDC have decided not to issue us with prepaid meters, only outrageous estimated billings. NERC says, give them. Izana says, increase in tariff is a scam. The discos are using estimated bills at the expense of Nigerians who are paying for darkness. And Carrier Hub says, and is attacking Morayo. Just the way Morayo appears to stand this morning, most Nigerians, once they can afford the service, they don't care who suffers. And the last one, Solid Truth says, when Fashola says things have increased, what are these things? Remember, there's variable costs. Also, price of gas has reduced.
Okay. Let's take a quick break now. When we come back, more on this matter. Stay with us. We'll be right back. Welcome back. Now let's go back to the basics. The reason of this protest, the tariff issue, that 10 naira, 12 naira, whatever naira
increases,
it is.
Yeah.
What exactly is it for, and why? What's the benefit of that tariff exactly? What was NEC thinking? What was the minister thinking by asking us to pay that additional 10 naira?
Well, the position of the minister is that if you don't pay a cost-reflective tariff,
yes,
cost-reflective tariff simply means that if I buy this mug
at 5 naira,
mm-hmm. and plus my transportation, plus my markup, maybe I should sell at 7 naira.
Mm.
But then the question comes back again. Do I put markup and sell cups that I don't have?
Mm.
Or do I put cups I have on the shelf, put my markup, and ask to come and buy?
Mm.
That's the question.
So you think that is trying to make money from you to go and buy the cup?
What they are saying now is that if the tariff is not cost reflective, that investors won't bring in money.
Yes, that's what he said.
Right, that's what they're saying. Mm. But the question here is this, you see, if we keep digging, we'll just keep digging and we'll keep pulling out dust. When the discos were buying, when the private companies were buying up the discos, the idea we're giving was that they had the financial muscles to turn around these companies.
Exactly. True.
It was after they came in that realized that they went to commercial banks to go and take loans.
Hmm. They've been bailing them out.
I've been bailing them.
They've been using the bailouts to pay those loans that they took loans at commercial rates.
Exactly.
Do you agree that?
Let me take this call from Tony, please. 1 second. Good morning, Tony. Are you there?
Yeah, good morning.
Morning, go ahead, please.
This is a first time caller.
Yeah.
Welcome to the show.
Thank you. Please, I want to use this opportunity to let this complain. We are living at Agidin. These NEPA people, when they came like this, either they bring a bill, increase it with 3,000 plus. So, I don't know. I want to complain this.
Okay.
Thank you.
May I take three tweets quickly and then ask a question? MM says, if power supply is available and constant, paying wouldn't be a problem. We can't pay for what is not available. Thanks. Adioye says, we're forgetting the fact that these discos inherited an alien NEPA. They bought a bad product. Now we get to bear the brunt. Career Hub says, there is no justification whatsoever for tariff increments in Nigeria. It's sad that Nigerians don't care for each other. What is the way forward?
The man there said they bought alien companies. I think it's like I went to the market to go and buy a car. And
you didn't do your due diligence.
It still goes back to what I was talking about. This guy, you see where we are, you see the problem? These guys came to buy something without money. Is that for them to do their diligence, due diligence and see what they are buying? They too said to buy.
It was discounted. Mr. They didn't pay. In actual fact, they got equipped. They got things, facilities on ground
almost for free. Yes,
almost for that value. And I want to even.
But also forget that this is an industry that has not seen investment over 20 years.
With all the money that Obasanjo pumped in.
The Obasanjo pumping in Jonathan was just 1999 when he came in.
Jonathan also pumped in a lot. I remember when he visited. Wait. Ambara.
Before 1999, before the Obasanjo regime,
yes.
The power industry has not seen any improvement for over 20 years.
Okay, these private investors are out to make money.
Yes.
How can NERC make sure that, you know, they regulate this to protect consumers?
You see, that's the most unfortunate part. The most unfortunate part. NERC has shown so much disregard for the people they are supposed to be defending. They've shown so much distaste. If you talk to them in NERC, they'll be talking to you as if you don't know what you're talking about. Like,
so they're not supporting the
disco. Well, it's only natural. You see, okay, we are fighting the system.
Let me take this call from AG in Anopaja. AG?
Yeah.
Good morning.
The man is Eddie, not GG.
AG or AG? Sorry, I apologize. I'm so sorry.
Yeah. I want to say something about the tariff issue. Yes, my name is correct now. Mrs. Brown, I would like to address you with that name. I know you are working in PBC. I should be very, very careful of the issue. You should be careful about the choice of words you use. Otherwise, trace the things about the regime. I'm not calling about the thief. But somebody in this country died because of this power. From that time till now, how much has our government put into power? And up till now, we are talking about something. Have somebody said the man who came before this man now talking told us how much we have in this country in terms of generation. Now I'm asking this question: is it this tariff meant for everybody? Do you have tariff for big men and tariff for poor people? A big man can give his girlfriend $80,000 for minimum wage for taxi. All of you there know about it. So what are we talking about? Forget about all this debate. Instead of increasing, they should decrease it. They should decrease it. Okay. They are saying about 80,000 naira for minimum wage is too much for Nigerians. And you're talking about increasing tariff. So the woman in the back is saying about will not use life.
Right. Thank you very much, AG.
Please,
yes.
I'd like to say something. I think that we've already agreed on the solution being that metering. Once you have metering, I don't have any problem with the increase in tariff. I know I've already told my maid before now that once you step out of a room, you switch off the lights.
Yes.
You don't switch on the lights during the day because you don't need it.
Yes.
Because I know that I'm on pay as you go. But there's something else. Most developing areas, let's say like Lekki, Aja, or Arekpo and all those areas, when you build your house, you can't expect, even when you ask, knowing that you will pay your bills, that the discos covering your area should give you power. In most cases, I have a fact, you buy your pole by yourself,
your
transformer, you buy your wire, you erect it, and they will tell you, okay, this is the last transformer, oh yeah, connect it, then they will now come, and they will still collect money to help you do the connections.
All right.
So who is defending us on this count?
Who should? NERC.
Or NLC.
or your consumer protection
advocacy?
The advocacy group is just an NGO, and we can only do as much as we can, you know. And so far, well, we're doing our best. If you find yourself in that kind of
Is there any process ongoing to address?
No, there are rules already. There are rules.
What I wanted to shut up was that we're going to bring somebody from NERC and even Ikeja Discos. Very important. This, because this tariff issue is very, very hot right now. So we're going to, we're still going to go to their office again to see if we can get somebody, a senior officer, to come here, either from Ikeja Disco, Eko Disco, or NERC.
Yes.
Or even, can even get the minister himself to come here.
We need the minister.
Anyone else to come and tell us. So we really need to, when that happens, they can ask this question. But the truth is that there is the best we've agreed on this table is that we need to meet. And the NERC has also promised that estimated billing will stop. That you don't have to make that payment anymore, according to what I read. You're not supposed to make that payment anymore. You can actually challenge
it. There's
a resolution group they've put together that can actually take up these issues and ensure you don't have to make those payments. I read that in an article that over the weekend. So you can actually go up and see if you can make those complaints to that.
And then we should listen out for what the minister comes out with in his meeting today.
So it's all going. It's ongoing. Thank you so much, Oga, for coming. I'd like to thank Mr. Dagatola. I think he's still in the studio. Thank you so much for being here. We appreciate the labor. For those of labor that are going out today to protest, let's even see how that goes.
Yay!
All right, we have to round up the show, but please, I don't know if you guys are aware of the fact that Labi is planning a boat cruise.
On Saturday.
This Saturday, Valentine is this weekend. On Saturday, February 13th. Please come out. It's just, it's a 3-course meal. I think it's for the regular, it's 15,000. For VIP, it's 20, and VVIP is 25. The reason why it's like that is because there's a 3-course meal. There's dinner, there's comedy on board. There's a performing artist on board. There'll be celebrities on board. It's just a 2.5-hour boat cruise, a very, very big boat. Trust me, very big boat. And it's 2.5 weeks. We're going to cruise from Lekki all the way to Marina area with lights, music, dancing. It's going to be a fantastic experience. Trust me. That's where you want to bring your girlfriend, your wife.
If you're single, you can come on your own and enjoy yourself.
Please, for those of you who are bringing the boo, the extra boo, we are going to put it on TV. I don't want to discourage you, but if you have the extra boo, please, that's the number you should bring them, because we're going to show it on TV. If not, by that time at home, we'll see the person. So, but point is that, come on, let's celebrate with LABI, celebrity. She's bringing all her people, I don't want to tell you who and who is lined up, but she has some celebrity couples lined up, so come on, serenade the whole thing. So please come. There's a number. I think the advert's actually running. Yes. I'll get the number for you tomorrow, because I was going to mention it again tomorrow. I'll get the phone number for you to call to book, so that we know how many people are coming, so we can all prepare for you. All right. All right. Thank you so much again. We had a great time. See you tomorrow. Bye-bye.
Bye.